My name is Stefanie Dehnen. I'm currently the Executive Director of the Institute of Nanotechnology at Karlsruhe Institute of Technology. I'm at the same time a professor of inorganic chemistry at Karlsruhe Institute of Technology, and I've been a member of a cluster since nearly 2 years. I'm interested in objects that are down to the nano size, usually molecular objects or objects that are structured in a nano-sized way, like networks, for example, made of cluster molecules. And to distinguish that from nanoparticles, they are atomically precise. So you can count the atoms within these nano objects and get a lot of information, for example, about chemical bonding, about reactivities, and also how to fine-tune their properties, which is very important in the context of a cluster, and this also drives our interest in these particles. Well, being part of the cluster of excellence 3D Matter Made to Order gives us the opportunity to interact with people from very different fields, for example, physics, electrical engineering, polymer chemistry. And this broadens the opportunities we have in what we are doing with our cluster molecules. Printing them and forming devices out of these materials is a fantastic benefit for us and the width of our spectrum of opportunities. And the other way around, I think that we can also contribute to that cluster in a certain way, for example, by introducing cluster-based inorganic materials to the portfolio of what is being investigated. Our vision is usually to start out with a fundamental question. We want to find out how the atoms of different elements bind in our clusters to achieve, for example, certain reactivities and certain properties. And the second part is also to find out how these properties can be exploited and used, for example, in devices, in fine-tuning materials. And so we usually start out with the very fundamental knowledge that we want to increase and broaden, and then find our way into a vision that reaches out to solving very, very current problems together with colleagues, of course, in the cluster. Actually, as a child, I've dreamed of different things to become, for example, a teacher, a doctor, an artist, and to be honest, being a scientist kind of combines all of that. So I'm a teacher, of course, in the university. I'm kind of a doctor, if you will. And we are also artists in what we are doing. So we call this the art of synthesis. And I think there's also a lot of aesthetics combined with cluster molecules. So all together, and a writer, I wanted to be a writer. So being an author of scientific articles is also adding to that. So if I had known all of that when I was a child, I would have said, yes, it must be a scientist. The very normal message I would also give to anybody is if you're interested in any of the fields, then follow your interests. And there is no difference between a female or a male young person. I would give this message to all of them. In particular, to females, I would say, be just very self-confident in everything you want to do. And if there is anything that gives you the impression that there is kind of a disadvantage for female scientists in one of the STEM fields, just don't believe it, because there is no disadvantage. You have the same gifts. You have the same kind of thinking and opportunities, and I would say just do what you love. Well, there has been a lot of progress made in terms of the support that female scientists in particular enjoy nowadays. Of course, it's still a challenge to get into science at all, being a female or male scientist. This is mostly because the number of positions has not increased, on the contrary. But as a female scientist, you have much more support, you're much more accepted and even wanted in certain positions. But still, the ratio of female scientists is low, especially in the fields of chemistry and physics, for example. In biology, is a little bit more equal. Of course, I've had mentors who supported me a lot. All of them have been male. I think in those days when they supported me, it's not been very typical to be a female scientist, so I'm particularly thankful that they took the opportunity and supported me. Yet they did it in a different way than I would do it, or I do it nowadays. And I think I've learned both. I've learned many things that are positive, and I do copy that, but I've also seen room for improvement in this regard, and this is what I try to give to the next generation. So yes, I've had role models and mentors, but not the female ones, and I'm happy that I can be a female role model.